Hey everybody, I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
Back off, man. We're scientists.
So we're here to review a new George Clooney directed film called The Monuments Men, which if you've seen the trailers, is sort of being pitched as kind of like a bit of an Oceans movie, a bit of a war movie based on this true story about these guys, the Monuments Men, who had to make sure that Hitler did not destroy all of the valuable art.
The chaos that would ensue if Hitler got his hands on all this valuable art.
Yes. Now, I'm already losing it just thinking of this movie, because guess what, fans? I'm breaking out something that Mercy is more known for than me. But it is time to bring out our favorite Turtle Alert beacon, because oh my goodness, this movie was supposed to open in December and it got pushed. And Fox and Sony said, you know, we're just pushing it to give it a little bit more breathing room in the release schedule. No, it's because they saw it and they thought, oh my gosh, what the hell has George given us? This movie is so boring. Fantastic cast. Unbelievable cast. You hear the lineup and you think, how could this be a bad movie?
Yeah.
George Clooney,
right.
Matt Damon, Bill Murray, Cate Blanchett, and the list goes on. John Goodman. Lots of great people pop up in this thing. So boring. So much not happening. The movie shifts between three tones that are radically different. One that's basically like Ocean's 9. You know, it's got that breezy, like, they're going to pull a heist, they're going to do something tone. A serious war drama where, like, we're honoring the actual men who died here. And then lyrical tome poem full of metaphorical imagery like The Thin Red Line, where Clooney gives these long over voiceovers about, you know, the perils of war and the value of art. But it's all for naught because, as we're watching this movie, all the exciting stuff happens off camera. So they're like, hey, we hear this shipment of art is coming in. We got to rescue it. Cut to a room with two guys just sitting there going, hey, we rescued a bunch of art. It's pretty great that we rescued that art, eh? And you're like, holy shit. Why am I not seeing them rescue this art? And then a couple characters get killed trying to rescue some art, but we don't know why they're there or what's happening because it's all so muddled. And then the rest of the movie, they're like, man, we're doing this for him because he sacrificed and did so much. And like, there's really teary moments where we're supposed to care about these characters who died. But other than the fact that they're based on real people who their contribution, their real life efforts, you know, bravo to them for sure. But as presented in the movie, just could not give less of a fuck than they do when you're watching this. So it was one of those things where I would say, if you think you want to see Monuments Men, based on the really good marketing, wait for TV. Oh my God, wait for TV.
Now, I really wanted to see this one. I got snowed in.
Yeah. So
here's another one that I'm just sitting here, you know.
Lucky you.
I'm here.
The
just...
best snowstorm ever.
I'm just here for the sparkling conversation, not to actually review the movie. But George Clooney, what he did in Gravity, really, like, I never had a really high opinion of him anyway. I think he's always been a one-trick pony. The only time he really surprised me and impressed me was in The Descendants, in that scene with his wife in the hospital.
Fantastic.
That's what I always knew he had in him. And but in Gravity, he was just so monotone. Every single line was delivered the exact same way. Don't worry, we're in space. What could happen? Oh, something catastrophic has happened.
That is exactly clear.
You're gonna make it. I'm not. Wow, look at the sun on the mountains. Like, every line is delivered the same way.
Mm-hmm.
So does he do that in this one?
He's hardly in this one, to be honest with you.
He directed it. So
he directed it, and his character doesn't get much screen time, but he is sort of just doing the same Clooney shtick as always.
What's wrong with
him?
Yes. What is he doing?
With this one, he was busy writing, producing, and directing, but, like, I can't even fathom that, like, this guy thought this was a great movie he was putting out.
Yeah.
And it's just, we shift so wildly from, you know, like I said, a character gets killed, and it's supposed to be sad, and then we've got a scene with Bill Murray and Bob Balaban, and they're sort of doing, like, a Laurel and Hardy routine. Then we've got a scene where Bill Murray hears a record from his family back home saying hi to him, and he starts weeping in the shower. And you're like, what the fuck is this movie? Why is it funny and light 1 minute and then heavy-handed and overwrought the next? Huh. It just can't settle on a tone. And when we finally get any good scenes of you know, the Nazis doing anything or them rescuing Art. It's too little, too late. So in an hour and 50 minutes, there was 20 tolerable minutes, and that is not enough for me to say anyone should go see this.
That's really too bad. One of my favorite old school movies is Kelly's Heroes with Clint Eastwood, and this one really had that vibe to it.
Mm-hmm.
A bunch of soldiers during a war who go off and do their own little thing that has really not much to do with,
right,
with the war that's going on. So it's too bad to hear that this doesn't really measure up to that old classic. Bill Murray, I think he's the funniest guy in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
I call him the master.
Yeah, I love Bill Murray.
He is precision comedy, and it's nice to know that he's still funny in this one, right? And
yeah,
he's been trying to do the dramatic stuff lately, but pick one.
Right. And even he's a guy that, even when he does drama, there's still something innately funny about Bill Murray, so it usually brings a little bit of comedy maybe to the tragedy. And his is the only stuff that almost sort of works.
Mm.
So for best part, worst part, I'm going to say best part, Bill Murray.
Yeah, the master.
Bill Murray and Jean Dujardin from The Artist, who's in this as one of the soldiers.
Cool.
He's still just a charming guy, and it's nice to see him actually get some speaking roles now. Worst part, Clooney's script, Clooney's direction. Clooney, what were you doing with this one, man?
Shocking, because he's been good before. Some mm-hmm. of the stuff he's directed. Has he written those movies, too, that he directed?
So there were a few movies that he wrote and directed, but a lot of them he was working with other people's scripts.
Okay.
So this movie most reminds me of, Clooney did a movie a few years ago called Leatherheads.
Oh, yeah.
About whatever it was about. I hated it so much. And it was like, on paper, it sounded great, had a great cast. And then you went and saw it, and it was just one of the most boring movies you've ever seen.
Yeah, I remember.
Same thing
that one
happened.
Off.
Same thing happened with this. So he pulled a leatherheads on Monuments Men. If that means anything to you, you should know better.
Okay. Well, that's Monuments Men. Wait for Netflix or video.
I would say yes. Definitely wait, because I'm giving it the old turd alert. Never again.
Even still, it's got John Goodman in it. It's got Bill Murray, the master, in it. That's enough for me, even if it's the most boring movie ever. I
give it a shot.
Those guys in it. And what does Johnny Goodman do in it?
He's in it for like 10 minutes. He's a sidekick to Jean Dujardin from The Artist. And that's about it.
Right. Thanks a lot for watching. Until next time.
Enjoy the show.
We came, we saw, we kicked its ass!